Sandstorm is still going strong, but I knew that there was one new base. Bones base is just right down there, so let's check out this one. Here's the coordinates. Howdy folks, and welcome back to ARK Scorched Earth Adventures with me, Scryptar, yay, and little Miss Ginger. And I think we're going to keep her as our main Jerboa going forward. I like how that color scheme matches the rest. And I've bred a couple times more to see if we can get any more blackness on those stripes on the back, and I just don't see it happening. So we're going to stick to it. It's fine. It was our first try, and it worked beautifully, and we're going to keep her, and it's all good. If you have any complaints about that, put it in the comments. So today it's time for another server tour, and I thought, you know, as always, we start over here to see what changed. Not much over here. Wiki Jabo is sitting on a box for no good reason. The greenhouse is going strong, no problems there. Still haven't done anything with it yet, and most of the veggies I'm going to ferry over to Mortuary to make kibbles. I don't think he has his greenhouse set up and running yet, but he does have all the eggs from us. And Blood Eagle is painted, Messerschmitt is painted, even MacGyver is painted. Lovely camo pattern here, desert camo. Looks quite nice. You can all find all the templates I've been using for this on arctemplates.com and arcpaint.com. So go ahead and have a look. Rex is painted, our stupid level 120 perfect tame. I generally only do this to 120 perfect tames, except for Blood Eagle, because he was our first RG. Not painting any Jabo or anything, I think that's just not enough room for a texture there. Yay, down here. We added Structures Plus for a number of reasons, most of them boil down to not being able to build structures where we wanted to place them, you know, conflicting with the terrain environment and whatever, so that's definitely a good thing. We're going to start playing around with that. I'm trying to keep this vanilla as possible. We have some quality of life mods in here, like the Builder's Helmet, something that should be in vanilla, like pick-upable structures. And the stack mod to make resource gathering not as much of a pain, because, you know, we're trying to make YouTube videos here. We can't spend 8 hours on gathering 2 stones. Structures Plus gives you some more interesting things in the latest updates. You can cycle transparency for glass items, you can select a different model for glass items, and you have this resource puller. And as far as I understand, any Structures Plus structure with an inventory, like the chemistry bench or industrial grill, maybe even smithy, all of that, they can do that. You just go there and you say, okay, I want to craft something, I'm missing the resources, and then you just say, okay, check the storage in the area surrounding this workstation, and you can pull the resources from there into this workstation and then craft your recipe. So that is definitely something I've been missing here for a long, long time. That would be cool, because we can basically just go and take, finally, go out there, get all the stone, come back here within range of, let's say, our smithy. Just park it here, go over to the smithy, highlight the radial menu and just say here, pull resources. And then it will show up the inventory of, what's his name? Finally, her, right? Yeah, her. Hey, I do remember things. Oh, finally, and you can just pull out all the resources you need. We'll see. For now, let's have a look around. Other than painting dinosaurs, nothing much has changed down here. There's our taming pen, which we haven't used yet. The breeding platform is heavily in use by pretty much everyone on the server, which is great. I like to see my structures being used. That makes me feel accomplished. Then up here, we have our Maison de Scryptar. I need to put a sign here that shows that this is our bedroom with our propaganda platform and everything. I haven't done any interior decorating yet. I think I haven't even painted that missing texture over here. No, I haven't. We'll see if I do that. Or when I do that, I definitely will do that. I did want to put down some water tanks and everything, and we still have this area here. Currently, this is a landing platform for whenever we want to log out in here, once that's actually done and functions as a bedroom, but I think I might want to do a little house over there, something of this size, or maybe a bit smaller. You do know that I share this base with my good buddy Kami, who hasn't logged in a while, but once he does, I want this house down there to be a crafting and similar things structure, no bedroom whatsoever. So it would be nice to have his own little house up there where he can store his private things, you know, blueprints and armor and skins and all of that. Then we have all our wyverns. And let me just get on our lovely lightning wyvern. What's your name? Night Fury, sure. And let's have a fly around. It's time for the base tour. Or server tour. Or tour in general. Let's just take a tour. First stop on the list over there is the Sunken City where we did our breeding and caving episode. And down here is Braddock's base. And as you can see, he did quite some stuff. We have another extension. That right part wasn't finished the last time. So let's get down here without dying. Thank you. And have a little look around. Knock, knock. He should be logged in. So we might see him running around here. Remember that staircase? Remember when we first came here, this was pretty much it. A nice open space and some staircases and some fabrication stuff. That looks good. Cooker, everything. Yeah, we had that the last time already. Let's see. Can we get in there from up here? No. So we have to go downstairs for that. Anything up here? Looks like he has tamed a couple more things. They look awesome. Natural desert camo, I like that. In here, that's still the one fire wyvern thing. That's good. That's not supposed to go that way, but okay. I also needed to replace my staircase because one more time I fell into the gap like right here. You know, we have a wall going this way and a wall going this way, and if you get stuck in here, you're stuck in midair and you can't get out. I wasn't wearing the builder's helmet at that time, so I had to destroy either the staircase or two or three walls, and I just destroyed the staircase and put up one of the wooden ones we saved from the walls we tore down. So around here, also, nothing much has changed. Well, it has changed since the last server tour, but not since the last time we've been here, which is when we pranked him with coloring the mantis and the rex. Note is still in here. Don't know if you had seen that. Pranks didn't go so well. Most of the people just liked what I did. For example, Predox liked the color of the mantis. So, well, if you're into psychedelic mantises, mantai, mantarinos, that thing, then yeah, sure, why not? I don't mind. So there's not much to see here. Predox has been taming a lot and building a lot. It's just with a base this size, it takes a while until all the walls are done. And, you know, you can only put stuff in there when the walls are done. So this is a lot of building. That's great. It's a huge build. I mean, not everybody can say he has two behemoth gates included in the base structure of the base. And it's not quite just a box, which is always nice. No, next base, which will be a CD, hasn't done anything since. He's been busy with, you know, school and all that, real life things. Everything is still here. Everything seems to be fine. The feeding trough is still filled up. But I will check on that in a second. But you've seen this base when we volunteered to paint the whole thing. Sort of. So let's move on. And we're here at the community center, you know that place. We spent the first couple episodes here, and nothing much changed. Nothing much changed since the last server tour or the very first one. We do have two or three new members on the server, but they started off on their own, like CD did, not using any of the amenities we have basically set up for everybody to use. So not really been used that much. I think at one stage the dinosaurs will just die out because they're out of food. That's just one of the things that happens. And that's okay. I mean, that's what we built the community center for. You can use it. You don't have to. If you want to get a head start, then just use it. That city's old place. Still here. He still needs to clear that out, and he wants to. But then again, he's not online currently, which, you know, is totally understandable. Real life sometimes takes precedence. Sometimes. Not very often. We're all procrastinators. And over here, you know that place. Right? I think that's still Apox and nothing much changed over here. He is still active, he is still online, he just didn't find much time lately, which goes lately saying the last couple of weeks. So that will change, but not currently. Over here, we finally confirmed this is a Predox starter place. No, we were wondering about that the first and the second server tour. Can I land? I've used this place when I was hunting Gerboas because it was fairly central. Good spot to land. And I could just drop them here, knowing that they would be protected by everything that's running around here, and nothing bad would spawn in this area, and this is on a plateau, nothing can come up here except for over there, where we have the big cuddle of dinosaurs standing around, which is great for us then. Actually, Predox flew by while I was doing the whole tame, and he has a good overview over his dinosaurs, because the first thing he spotted was that Jaboa we left over there, the one. When I just started collecting them, and he went crazy in the chat like, "Oh, who's using my base? Who tamed a Jaboa here?" And yeah, that was fun for me, sort of. Let's move on. And now we're over at Mortuary's base. He got electricity going. That's good. Seems like that light is damaged over there. It looks a little bit dark. The turbine is not doing much. Well, it seems to be doing something currently because the cable is yellow. But then again, 65% wind, same as in our base, I believe. Or did we have 45 or something? I don't know. So he has a solar panel hooked up here, which is powering the whole base. He also got his first Vivern going. It's a fire one. It looks absolutely gorgeous, like Scorched Earth colors, all sandy camouflage-like. Astaroth. You a lady or a dude? You a dude! How you doing? Good. let's put the GPS away. You've seen the coordinates. And you know where this place is, right? I mean, it's the biggest base we have around here in terms of structures and footprint. I think the only rival is our base in terms of footprint, but for us, it's mostly the fence and the wide open area. And this is actually structures, a lot of them. So there is some sort of a trick to actually getting down there from up here, which is go down here. And then go down here, and then you're in. So he will definitely benefit from the structures plus idea. I mean, you see this. This is the gate. This works all fine. And then you come over here, you see this. This didn't really connect the way he wanted. There was stuff in the way and like that. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. And he fiddled around with this for hours on end. Like that. Why would that just not close off? And yeah, so he will be happy to see Structures Plus in action here. Especially since Structures Plus also allows you to build without supports. So he could just go through here, have like one foundation, have all these ceilings flush with the foundations, which is one of the things that Structures Plus does for you. It just lowers these snap points a little bit so they're flush with the actual foundations. And you basically just need one foundation in the middle somewhere, and the rest can be all ceilings. You don't need any pillars or anything. We'll see if we want to go to that extent. That's a server config thing. But then there are more things. You know, you can put in a sloped wall thing support there, and usually that would connect to the underside of that sloped roof, but you can make it connect to the upside, to the upper side. Just invert the whole thing, so you don't need a whole wall there. All of this, like, little quality of life. So what changed over here? Well, we have a chemistry bench. We have the solar panel mod, obviously, here. Other than that, I guess a few more tames. Ooh, ah, there's no ramp there. I found the door last time we were missing out on that door. Our little prank that, again, didn't really turn out into to be a prank because he just liked that. It's a little bit bright, he said. So I might want to see if I find a different... it's called Spitfire, that template. If I find a different one that does the same but a little bit darker, and then I might repaint that and, well, not prank him again. It's like not dash prank. It's the one thing. Eggs are somewhere over here. Right there. Ooh, that looks nice. Maybe you should be, like, up there. Level 100? I think that's one of... ours? Might have been one he found himself, but we had two of those. 92? Yeah, that's nice. The one he hatched is definitely a higher one. And Rex eggs and all of that comes from our base. Vulture egg as well, I found those. So, yeah. That's good. Where is... Oh, you got stuck there. That's perfect. You just stay stuck there. That's awesome. So, let me get back on top and then we continue our little server tour. And we're approaching Steppy's place. Now, let's have a look over here. So there's Steppy's base, and he also hatched a fire wyvern thing. He has had not much luck with his breeds and tames. I mean, this area is pretty dangerous. You have to grant him that. But then, if you've seen his episodes, I did it. What? Yeah, I did it. Not idiot. I did it. Perfect. He was trying to tame a mantis for ages and it didn't really work out. Issues with bug repellent and everything. Eventually, he made this greenhouse down there, which we are going to have a look at in a second. And then it seems like he finally managed. That episode, as far as I know, is not out yet at time of recording this. But when you are watching this episode, I guess it will be done. Fire Chasm. He corrected the name. That's nice. Gorgeous looking fella. Nice. Looks like ours before it was painted. I'm not gonna paint that. Unless he wants me to. Sparky, level 64. Was a low level one when he bred that egg. Also, you might have noticed that there's two painted RGs now. He immediately renamed this one Parrot. And then asked me, after he found out that it was I who pranked him, if I could basically paint Baby as well, because he really did like that color scheme and wanted it on his main RG for whatever reason. Alright, it's again a prank that really didn't work out to be a prank. I have to come up with something else. Maybe I should just convert all of the bases into metal or something. Or stone. That would be a really mean prank, because then everybody would wake up and die instantly of heat. That's not a good idea. That's too much work for them to clear up the mess. That's not really a prank that I would like to do. That's mean. So down here, there's three water veins, and he has enclosed two of them. That looks neat, with this little bulge there. And this seems to be like a flyer-only access type of greenhouse deal, because there's no door. Man, thank you. What? That's some weird placement. I guess there's a reason for that. There's also a reason for us to come up here. But this looks like a working greenhouse. Is there a door somewhere, or did we just block that off? Or do you have to fly in here? Oh, it's right here. Yeah. Can I? Please? Stop that. Seems like these taps are really sunk into the ground, and it's definitely one more tap than I expect you would need. That there should cover the whole area, but yeah, why not? Rather have more than less, you know? Redundancy and stuff. It's good. Stop that. I want to close the door. Thank you. Alright, so that's Steppy's base. He's been busy with tames and losing tames, and he's been busy with extending that down there. So it's not much over here. Let me just quickly get inside and have a look. I think you finally got chemistry bench and all of that going as well. Yeah, chemistry bench is there. Steppy is there. Hi. Can we? No poop. Can't poop. Okay, so can't leave him a present here. That's good. I guess he doesn't mind. Got some more dung beetles. Nice looking jabor. I like that. Yeah, not much in here. He's been not that busy with his channel lately. He's coming back online to get into full swing. I expect great things here. It's looking great. I mean, if he does something, he does it right, it would seem. It just takes him a while to do something. So it might take a while until we see a major extension here. But it's coming along. That's good. He has had a lot of setbacks. It's good to see him still being here and not giving up on this. So off to Bowden's place. And we found Bowden's place. Not really that difficult to find. You all know where it is. Here's the coordinates, just in case. Put that away. And he has made the bridge into a Vivern dragon thing platform type of deal, which is nice. I mean, you can't use this open area for anything if you're building downstairs. But if you have to block this off so nothing falls down into your base, might as well use it for dinosaur storage, right? I mean, I would have done the same pretty much. Feeding trough down here. I guess there's one or two more over there to cover the whole area. Can I get my hut? Thank you. Ghost Rider! Oh, his main mount is far, counting only Vivrens as mounts here, sits up here. So I guess all of these are basically the ones he hatched but is not using on a permanent basis. There's also a gravestone here for Cortana. You might want to check the last episode. So from where you are standing, that's like yesterday or the day before, where he lost his day one Jerboa, same as we did. we have here? Little logout hut, some crafting tools, basically so he doesn't have to get downstairs all the time when he wants to do some stuff up here, which is good. There is a platform up here for an elevator. Oh, don't fall. It goes somewhere down there. Can I emote? Yay, there you go. That's this big elevator platform. You can't see the elevator platform itself because it's sunken into those foundations. So you basically pillar down. See those pillars there? Wow, that's not good for Vertigo. Pillar down, then put the elevator in there, and then attach the foundations. That makes the platform of the elevator sunken into those foundations. This is all looking nice. He told me not to come over here because my OCD would kick in, but he's done a pretty good job here, I would say. That is looking nice. Really looking nice. Get a weather change here soon. Alright, let's do this quickly then. We have a new breeding platform, some ACs. It's not quite as extensive as ours, but it does the job, I would say. Got his own solar panel. That seems to be the middle of the platform. Nice paint job. Light blue, dark blue, something like that. Let's see. Nope, that one. Hyperthermal 1677. Yeah, it's not bad. That should be enough for a Vivan Dragon thing to hatch. That's Stormy. That seems to be his go-to guy at the moment. So close. Tucked under the wings. Very good, very good. Stairway to Heaven? Where are you going? Oh, where really? Alright. We're trying to connect over there. I don't know what this is going to be. This might just be a silly little project testing the building height maximum. Or it might be something that's really useful, like getting up there without having to use the elevator, maybe? I don't know. We will find out soon. Sandstorm. Let's check out the inside. Oh, he does have a painting here. See, in the prank episode, we were looking for paintings, and we couldn't find any. So, that's good. Also, this prank went completely wrong. For some reason, none of the paint jobs were visible when he logged in, and I actually came over. I showed him a screenshot of the episode, and he said, "Are you, like, trolling me? Because there's nothing here." And I came over, and there was nothing here. You see that picture we put on here with the troll face? That's gone. It's not gone. It was never there. The paint shop for the, what's it called, the stone golem rubber thing, earth elemental, you here? You're somewhere here. Anyway, can't see you. That was gone, and the picture we put up in his bedroom, where's his bedroom? It's one down. That was there, but it was blank. Is that under here? Yeah, well now that seems to be gone as well. So you got a free picture. Alright. Sandstorm is still going strong, but I knew that there was one new base. Bones base is just right down there, so let's check out this one. Here's the coordinates. Let's go down there, let's find out what this deal is all about. There's a lot of gates here. Well, the easiest way to block that off. Thornicles. Thornicles? Are we baywatching? Yes, we are baywatching. Dum, 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 dum. This is looking nice. Ghost Rider. Hmm. So somebody had the same thought as Odin. That's okay. Eagle Maddox Inc. Alright. Stinger. You notice that these are quests, right? So they've been transferred over. They're fairly high level. That's quite neat. I like this type of building. I like how this slope where you can't build really is the perfect placement for a staircase. Because you can't do anything here anyway. That's cool. And the grill is running. Let's have a quick look. Yeah, that's running, so let's leave it run. Somebody's been busy working here. Can I get through here? Thank you. Hello? Anybody home? Snuggles? Oh, you're cute. I like your colors. Why wouldn't I? This is Eagle. Little Eagle. Perfect, so that's his new base. I don't know if this is going to be a starter base or the main base, but it definitely looks gorgeous already. Got a fireplace down there. I don't know if that isn't kind of a bit of a waste, but alright, why not? A lot of preserving bins. Interesting loft type deal going on in here. Makes it hard to find a house buff anywhere, but yeah. Man, This guy is good. I like the architecture. I like that very much. I think I need to get together with him and learn some tricks here. Okay, don't want to spoil too much. He hasn't started recording yet, so this will be an interesting thing to record how this was done when it was already done. And tanks place. So we've been here last when we did the pranks. There still is the psychedelic Ankylo, and I think the Dodik is running around somewhere over there. Another prank that didn't go as planned, because shortly after, he came over to my base to hatch that Vivern, and we did this together. Looks nice. That's an eagle for you. Looks like a duck. I don't know. So he now does have... Stuck! Do not get stuck in the butt of the other eagle there. Thank you. That's good. So he now does have a lightning Vivern Wyvern dragon thing. That's cool. I think that's one of the level 100 eggs we had in a storage, because he did have a fire Vivern, which he hatched our platform, and then he took out for leveling, and then he died, and we rescued it, and then he went to come and get it, and then he died again, and this time the Vivern died as well, and then he just took our egg, which that was four, right? I mean, we put that there for everybody to be able to take it, and he took us up on the offer and just hatched that one. It looks gorgeous. I like it. I actually like those colors, this light blue in there compared to that purple. I like it. It's cool. We had a quick look over here during the prank episode, so it's not much that changed, as you can see. There's Rainbow Dodig. Let's just have a quick look here. No changes in here. That looks still fairly interesting. Yep, still need a chemistry bench and all of that. So he's been busy trying to get a Vivern to hatch and level and stay alive. And of course he's been busy on all the other stuff. We're currently doing Hearts of Iron 4 together, and he's running two or three other Hearts of Iron campaigns at the moment. And, you know, ARK is one of those things he does, but it's not the main thing, I would say. That's pretty much the same for me. You know, I'm currently running four different series, and so this is 25% of the time. And for him, it's like, I don't know, 15%. That raptor over there will not want to go there. That's stupid. Oh well. So, that's it for the server tour. There have been a couple of changes, but not that many changes. Everybody has been busy with Vivern Vyverns, and everybody has been busy with new tames, and now we're all getting into Structures Plus. I think we will get more building done, so there's more to show. We'll see. I'm not quite sure what we are going to do next. We still have a Rock Elemental Taming platform on the list. We still have that House for Kami on the list. Maybe some beautifying around this platform. Actually getting quite good at landing here now. I've been doing that for a couple of times. Still need to maneuver a little to get this set. Thank you. And we didn't die. And little Miss Ginger is still alive. So I guess that's a successful episode. Just put right here. Aha. So, that's it for today, folks. If you like the video, subscribe for more. Leave a comment if you feel like it. Don't forget to enjoy yourselves. See you soon.